Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Yes, this is the third video for today. I'm already exhausted, but we have a lot of stuff to cover today, and I want to make it as fast as possible because it's important. Twitter picked up yesterday an old post, a 2 months old post. It's Coin Bureau's video about Elrond. He raised some concerns, they were answered, but I was just thinking, yeah, let's just refresh our memory. Let's cover it. So, for those who don't know Coin Bureau, but I'm sure that most of you who are following me, you are following him as well for a longer time. It is a very big channel. He has 1.05 million subscribers. He covered Elrond in one of his April's videos and he raised some concerns. I'm not gonna repeat everything, but the two major concerns which made him to stay on the sidelines, since then we don't know what is his position, was that he could see on the wallet's addresses that the majority of the Elrond, big amount of Elrond is on a few wallets. The other concern was that the ERD tokens which are still not swapped for e-gold coins are not included in the total supply. Now, this is not a very, very big amount comparing to the 17 million which we have in circulation right now, or circulation, or minted. We have still in ERD tokens 166,000 worth of Elrond coins. Therefore, the supply wouldn't just double or triple, which could just slash the price. Nevertheless, this was confirmed that the ERD tokens are included into the total supply. Now, the other concern, which I just mentioned first, that the majority of the Elrond of the Elrond coins is owned by just a few wallets. He said that those are probably whales and they could dump Elrond and the price could crash. Now, that was also answered by Elrond team, and those wallets are not whale wallets, are not private wallets. Those are exchange wallets distributed to the exchange clients. Therefore, on Elrond mainnet, when you see one wallet with, I don't know, 3 million Elrond coins, that is one exchange, being Binance or Bitpanda right now, as it was confirmed that 3 million Elrond is distributed to all of their clients. Now, this is good news. Since that video, Guy didn't answer any of the Elrond community's question, and we don't know what is his position right now. Please keep in mind, he's an Ethereum guy, but still at the end of his video, he mentioned that Elrond's smart contract is better than Ethereum's version 2, which is not out yet and probably will be delayed. Also, he said that Elrond checks all the boxes, and if these whale wallets are not true and the ERD tokens are included in the total supply, this is a pretty good project. And that is big words from somebody with such subscribers. Therefore, in the overall, I know that many of you attacked him, maybe not you who are watching me, but some from the Elrond community. I think this review from him was a good review, and with setting straight these misconceptions, these concerns could lead into more and more people buying into Elrond. Now, my question to Guy: are you still on the sidelines? And since this video is not a subscribers hunters, please don't answer it. I know that your videos are not reaction videos, and I appreciate that. All I'm asking you is to tweet "I'm in" without tags. Don't tag anything, because since I'm following you, I will know. Of course, I cannot promise that I will not retweet. Thank you for watching, and yeah, if you could answer, that would be highly appreciated. Take care.